Hey everyone, hi, I'm Abhi.
And I'm Neo.
And today we have a very special guest with us, Gurudev Sri Sri Ravi Shankar.
Gurudev Sri Sri Ravi Shankar is a founder of The Art of Living. It's a volunteer-based humanitarian organization that has centers in more than 156 countries worldwide.
They work for health, education, sustainable development, disaster relief, and conflict resolution. The Art of Living has several different programs to reduce stress and find peace and happiness.
Universities like Stanford offer Yes Plus, a course taught by The Art of Living that teaches a breathing technique called the Sudarshan Kriya as an academic course credit.
We asked our followers to meditate for 21 days and there were a lot of questions. In this conversation, we spoke to Gurudev about meditation, the environment, and the power of youth. So if you're new over here, please subscribe to our channel and let's begin.
Abhi and you?
Yes, hi Ruchi.
How are you?
Good.
You have become more and more creative in the lockdown. You are a great couple.
So many youngsters say that I am too young to meditate. So is there any right age to start meditating?
First of all, to drive a car, you can't say you are too young. If you are too young, you will never be asked to drive also. Right? So if you are of the age of driving a car, then you are fit to meditate also. Since you have a driving license to drive a car, you should also have a driving license to drive your own life. If you want to have your own dream, your own ideas, you need to meditate. Because meditation gives you brilliant ideas, number one. Second, is meditation not for students? Yes, it is for students. Because students need the brain power. Don't you need brain power? If you don't need brain power, no need to meditate. So you need more intuition, you need intelligence, you need to grow in your memory, you need to have strong memory and sharp intellect. And meditation is needed for these things.
Gurudev, what happens to your brain when you start meditating?
You know, there is the central part of the brain called amygdala that starts shrinking. When amygdala becomes bigger, then you get nervousness, you have many emotional turbulences. Here, it has an impact on amygdala. It has impact on your gray matter in the brain. So what scientists say is the gray matter increases. So if you want to be brainy youngster, you better meditate.
So if someone is depressed, will meditating make the situation even worse?
No. So many people who are depressed, they come and they do meditation and without medication, they can get better. They have gotten better. And NIMHANS, you know, National Institute of Mental Health has also recommended Sudarshan Kriya for people, who are undergoing depression. Yeah. It's used even as a treatment in many places. Not just in India, in Canada, in Ontario, in Canada and in many other places. Yeah.
Gurudev, what is the importance of our breath? How can we use the breath to control our minds?
When you get angry, notice how your breath is. You know, you breathe faster when you are happy. When you see a beautiful scenery, you breathe differently. And when you meet someone very beloved to you, your loved one, your breath changes, isn't it? So, our breath is linked to our emotions and sensations in the body. So, learning a little bit about breath is always useful. So, you can be master of your mood. Suppose you get some bad remarks from one of your friends and your mood is off and it continues the whole day, but you want to be master of that, then use breath, then you will find in just short few minutes you're back, your mood is in your control.
Gurudev, can you explain the link between intention, attention and manifestation? How can one person go from intention to manifestation?
You know, what you want, first it should be very clear in your mind. Many times we don't know what we really want. You know, we live in a state of confusion. And since the mind is so confused, it is not really putting its attention on what it wants, what you want. So first, the clarity in understanding or your wish or what you want really. When that comes up, then you have the intention. The intention, then you put your attention on that. You will see this start manifesting. See, all our actions happen through intention. You intend to go to a movie. That thought just came to you and you do everything with that thought, right? You wanted to go to Mumbai, you want to go to Delhi. That one single thought propels the whole action till you complete what you intend to. But with meditation, when you have the intention and you put a little attention in meditation, after meditation, you will find that it starts manifesting for you. But prerequisite for that will be good meditation. Yeah.
People say that we are living in Kali Yuga. The competition outside is so cutthroat that everyone is running a race. So everyone wants to succeed, whether it's immoral or moral, that question comes later. So how can one strike a balance in this approach?
You need to expand vision about your own life. So what is the goal in your life? I would recommend you to have two goals. One is for a bigger goal, what you want, how you want to see the whole world, how you want to see your country, how you want to see your state, you know. Have a goal for the nation, number one. Second, have a personal goal. Okay, I want to achieve this, this, this. Or I want to earn so much money. I want to earn so much fame. I want to do this, this. Whatever. I want to do so much service. So you sit down and map your own life. Put a framework to it. See, these are the things I want to do. You know, pinpoint, point out what really interests you. This half job is done then. The rest of the job is, you put focus on that, you know. Put your attention on that. That's what I would say, intention, attention. Then only it can start manifesting. So when you think of a goal for you like this, you have a bigger context in life. You know, see today young people, for small reasons, small things, a boyfriend or a girlfriend or some, if they break up with them, their heart breaks and they commit suicide. They lose a job, they get lower grades, they jump out of the window. You know, they should put an end to this sort of is tarah ki harkatein band kar dena chahiye inko. Just do Sudarshan Kriya, just meditate, you will see right away you are out of it. You feel so much better in just two sittings. In very first two sittings, you'll be able to get rid of this feeling. Your life is much more precious than some small achievements that you may think about. Okay, when you have a goal, when you want to achieve something, know that you will have competition. There'll be cutthroat competition. So go for it. And knowing very well, you may not succeed all the time. In competition, you will fail sometimes and you will succeed some other time. Success is not for sure in every competition, but it is for sure in your life.
Gurudev, in 2020, everyone is suffering. Students are worried about their exams. People have lost their jobs. So how should people deal with the situation that we're all in right now?
We must simply say 1 year is gone. 2020, don't count it at all. Ginti mein nahi aana chahiye. Gino hi mat. And then put your attention to develop your skills. See, more than a certificate, it is your skill which will fetch you job. If you look depressed, if you look sad, who would like to hire you, tell me? Will anyone hire you? You are looking so like that, like no juice, no life, and you look worried. If there is worry in someone's eyes, nobody is going to hire them. Nobody would like to do business with them, right? whom someone would like to do business with? Someone who is enthusiastic, someone who has the courage to face all these challenges, right? This is the time to enhance your courage. Wake up, I would say, wake up, enhance your courage, and then have confidence you'll be able to do it, right? And then put your 100%, put your 100%. Apna 100% dal dena, jo bhi kar rahe ho usmein. Dekha jayega. So, COVID ki chinta karni nahi chahiye. You should not worry about this COVID at this moment. You have to be careful. But you know, like many other diseases which had come in the human society, this is also one such. This will also go away, and there will be a solution for it too.
So speaking about the power of youth, you said that everyone should have one personal goal and one goal for the world. So how can youth change the world? What is the power of the youth?
If you look back, all the big movements in the world have started by youth only. See, freedom movement, lots of youths were there in that. School teachers, headmasters who were involved in the freedom movement. Salt Satyagraha, Dandi March, Swadeshi. I started Art of Living when I was only 23. And it has grown in the world in 156 countries. Millions of people are there without much effort. If you see Art of Living movement, it has 70% young people. 70% are all youth here. Yoga, World Yoga Day when we do. It's the youth who stood with the yoga and spread yoga throughout the world. 2 billion people practicing yoga. Most of them are young people only. In 2010, 12, 13 and all, we did India Against Corruption. I was there in that, we were one of the main people who started it. You know, it's Art of Living youth group which started India Against Corruption and Against Terrorism on 9th March 2009. And on the 10th, in 2010, it took a shape. That's when we invited Arvind Kejriwal, Kiran Bedi, and many others to join Anna Hazare to be part of this. A year later, then we made India Against Corruption. We only put Anna Hazare forward. So Anna Hazare said, I don't know anybody in Delhi, what I will do in Delhi. You come, we will organize everything for you. So Anna Hazare came and we all organized. It's all youth power. You know, it bought, of course, it took a different line, then it became a political party. That's a different thing. So Nirbhaya case, when Nirbhaya thing happened, one of my Art of Living, the volunteer from Delhi called me in the morning. This has happened. In the evening, we are going to do a candle light at India Gate. I said, go ahead. On 6 p.m. in the evening, 5,000 youths gathered with a candle and they did candlelight ceremony for Nirbhaya, justice for Nirbhaya. Then you see how it rolled into a big movement. Same way JP movement. JP movement was started by young people. Now, it should not be only a negative trend, you know. किसी चीज को ध्वंस करना हो तो यूथ खड़े हो जाते हैं. इट शुड नॉट बी ओनली टू डिमोलिश समथिंग बट टू ब्रिंग समथिंग न्यू ऑल्सो यंग पीपल शुड. बट इट्स द यूथ हु स्टार्ट वेदर इट इज फैशन वेदर इट इज एनी अदर पैशन फॉर द नेशन. इट्स यूथ हु इज ऑलवेज इन द फोरफ्रंट.
Moving on to the environment, both of us are very passionate about the environment. We talk about it very vocally. Let's go to one of India's deepest problems. Can you tell us something about India's water crisis?
Because we have not taken good care of water bodies. Gaon mein jo water bodies hote hain na, usme dump kar dete hain. Garbage dump kar dete hain. Ye sab nahi karna chahiye. Puja ke naam se plastic bhi dal dete hain, styrofoam dal dete hain, sab dal dete hain. ये सब नहीं करना चाहिए. वी शुड बी एनवायरमेंटली वेरी कॉन्शियस. नाउ गणेशा इज कमिंग, वी शुड सी दैट यू नो वी डू गणेश फ्रॉम जस्ट मेन क्ले ओनली एंड डू ओनली वेजिटेबल पेंट्स ऑन दैट. Biodegradable painting and you know environmentally friendly Ganeshas. Otherwise, we bring such toxic paints, make Ganesha looks very beautiful, but then when you immerse it in the water, so many fishes die in the water bodies. ये नहीं होना चाहिए. I'm sure. I think you also did something with the eco-friendly Ganesha, right? You were also initiating it. This is very important. I have also been telling we should do Ganpati with vegetable colors, water colors, which are non-toxic, or you don't need colors. Just make Ganpati out of clay and then do Visarjan. Same with Durga Puja, we throw so much of those, you know, materials, plastics and other things, which pollutes the ocean. Not just the pujas, even otherwise, see how much plastics we are dumping. We should be very careful when we use plastics and preserve our water bodies, rivers and lakes. We should see that nale ka pani usme na gire. Kya karte hain hum, ghar ki jo ye sab khachade khachade sab hote hain na, nale, सारे नाले जाके वो तालाब में मिल जाती है, फिर तालाब की पानी फिर पीने लायक नहीं रहता है. तो ये गड़बड़ होता है. हमें वो हाइजीन पर बहुत ध्यान देना चाहिए.
What is the art of living doing to tackle climate change?
43 नदियों को रिजुविनेट किया. 43 रिवर्स हैव बीन रिजुविनेटेड. फिर हजारों वाटर बॉडी को रिवाइव किया गया है. सब वॉलंटियर्स बहुत उसमें इंटरेस्ट लेके कर रहे हैं. जितने सारे पेड़ लगवा रहे हैं जगह जगह, मैं कहता हूँ हर एक को 5 पेड़ तो लगाने चाहिए. करोड़ों में वृक्षारोपण की गए हैं. सो ये सब करते रहना चाहिए, मगर इन सबसे बहुत इम्पोर्टेंट है भाई, ये देखो मुस्कुराते रहना. तेरे चेहरे पे मुस्कान नहीं हो तो कुछ भी करोगे तो उसका वो जो है वो इतना पलपेगा नहीं, चमकेगा नहीं. तो हमें हमेशा ये ध्यान रखना चाहिए, जैसे हमारी चेतना होती है वैसे हमारा वातावरण होने लगता है. तो हमारी चेतना में यदि प्रसन्नता है, खूबी है, शांति है, एक तरह के सबके प्रति प्रेम है और कुछ डेडिकेशन है, देश के लिए कुछ करना, जनता के लिए कुछ करना, ये भाव है, तो आपका व्यक्तित्व चमक जाएगा. यू विल शाइन. यंग पीपल शुड हैव सच अ ज़ील एंड एंथुसियाज्म टू डू समथिंग टू द सोसाइटी. हमसे कुछ देश के लिए, दुनिया के लिए उपयोगी काम हो, ये भाव हर एक व्यक्ति रखे तो बहुत बढ़िया हो जाएगा. जैसे आप लोग कर रहे हो ना, यू बोथ आर इंस्पायरिंग सो मेनी यंग पीपल, राइट? तो ऐसे करते जाओ.
गुरुदेव, वी डिड अ 21-day मेडिटेशन चैलेंज ऑन इंस्टाग्राम एंड अ लॉट ऑफ पीपल पार्टिसिपेटेड एंड मेनी ऑफ देम हैड डाउट्स. सो दे आस्क्ड अस, हाउ मेनी टाइम्स शुड आई मेडिटेट इन अ डे? व्हाट इज द बेस्ट टाइम फॉर मेडिटेशन? एनी गाइडेंस ऑन दैट?
इट शुड बी डन बिफोर मील. भोजन करने के बाद तुरंत मेडिटेशन करेंगे तो नींद आ जाएगी. सो यू शुड डू मेडिटेशन इन ए कंफर्टेबल पॉज. आराम से बैठ जाए, बैठ के करना पड़ेगा, लेट के नहीं. बैठ के ध्यान करिए और 20-1 मिनट करें. शुरू शुरू में गाइडेड मेडिटेशन की आवश्यकता होगी. आप लोग डाउनलोड कर सकते हो, एक सत्वा ऐप है और आर्ट ऑफ लिविंग ऐप है, उसमें हमने कई तरह की मेडिटेशन कई भाषाओं में किया है. तो वो गाइडेड मेडिटेशन को यूज़ करके करें कुछ दिन, तो आसानी लगेगी आपको मेडिटेशन करने में. सो 20 मिनट दो बार कर ले काफ़ी है, या 3 बार करना चाहिए तो कर सकते हैं, पर बिफोर ब्रेकफास्ट और बिफोर डिनर करना चाहिए.
यू से दैट मेडिटेशन इज डीप रिलैक्सेशन. So what is meditation for you?
मेडिटेशन माने कोई श्रम नहीं है, बहुत परिश्रम करके करना, ऐसा नहीं. मेडिटेशन माने एक तरह का रेस्ट है, डीप रेस्ट, डीप रिलैक्सेशन, यही ध्यान है. लोग गलत समझ गए मेडिटेशन माने एकाग्र करो, फोकस योर माइंड, ये सब नहीं है. मेडिटेशन इज मस्ती, इट्स जस्ट रिजॉइसिंग इन योर सेल्फ. ओके, लवली.
So, did you like our conversation with Gurudev Shri Shri Ravi Shankar? Which guest would you like to see on our show next? Tell us in the comments below. See you again soon.